This is Dr. Lam welcoming you to our discussion on adrenal fatigue syndrome stage 3C, also called the disequilibrium phase. As you know, there are four phases to stage 3 adrenal exhaustion. And when you get to stage 3C, the body has already gone through 3A, which is characterized by HPA axis dysfunction, with symptoms like a hypoglycemia, low blood pressure, and beginning of a catabolic state, as well as stage 3B, while the downstream hormonal axis like the OAT axis are becoming dysfunctional. Here in stage 3C, we have gone beyond that. In other words, the body has continued to be damaged to such a point that it's lost its equilibrium. So, despite the previous symptoms, additional symptoms are going to be present here. So, in stage 3B, we see hypothyroidism, low energy, estrogen dominance, irregular period, as well as low libido. It's quite common. But in stage 3C, things get even worse and has more symptoms than that. Now remember, most people in stage 3B as well as stage 3C are able to work a full-time job most of the time. Depends on how things go. Now, the key to understand in stage 3C is here, the body continues to weaken, which triggers a variety of reserve system to spring into action to maintain the body's homeostasis. Much of this alarm response is driven by the sympathetic nervous system, or the SNS, with its chemical messenger norepinephrine, and the adrenal medullary hormonal system, the AHS, which is chemical messenger epinephrine. The SNS and AHS are collectively called the sympathetic system, or the SAS. Now, dysregulation of the chemical messengers, the epinephrine and norepinephrine of the SAS, is therefore the hallmark of this phase. Symptoms common of stage 3C includes anxiety attacks, heart palpitations, electrolyte imbalances, dizziness, severe insomnia, paradoxical and unusual reactions to medications and supplements. Crash can be frequent with longer than usual recovery period. Fatigue tends to be moderate to severe. A routine laboratory test continues to be negative. So the body is in a desperate mode. And this is where you see most of the people that come in to see you, because they've already been exhausted by their regular conventional doctors. They have been abandoned by their health practitioners, and they've been jumping around from doctors to doctors, and usually with no avail. Continued testing, even going to extensive neurotransmitter workup, brain scans to rule out tumors, pituitary masses, hypothalamic dysfunctions have all been negative, and their tolerance of supplements that was working before is now kind of starting to backfire, medication starting to backfire or increasing an ever larger dose. Insomnia becomes a key problematic area. Thyroid medication has to be increased, steroids may have to be increased, and the person is wired and tired at the end. So if you break down stage 3C, you can actually see a progression of early stage 3C, middle stage 3C, as well as late stage 3C. And the later you go, the more you see epinephrine type reactions, and the earlier it is, the less epinephrine and the more norepinephrine. So if a person just comes in and says, well, I have occasional heart palpitations, I have a mild anxiety feeling, that's not so bad. That is more of a norepinephrine or a sympathetic overtone. However, if your person comes in and says, well, I have impending doom, I have panic attack that's full blown, I have heart palpitations every time I stand up, I can hardly walk because I'm having low blood pressure, that is more symptomatic of a higher level of sympathetic involvement, as well as, more importantly, the adrenal hormonal medullary system, or the epinephrine component. So if you break it down, you will be able to sense where this person is at. Now, why is it important? It's because as the adrenal recovery progresses, you'll be able to see that reversal will happen. The epinephrine type effect will then start to tone down first, meaning the sense of impending doom, the panic attack, the dizziness will be the first thing to go away. And then the heart palpitation may continue to persist, and it will be the second thing to go away. So in other words, as a person recovers from adrenal fatigue, the epinephrine response will be the first one to resolve, and then is followed by the norepinephrine response as we progress further during the recovery period. It's very interesting if you are able to track these clients from the stage that they are in and how their advance is forward when they crash and how they actually recover and get better. And usually it does not take a long time. Even the people with stage 3C, if it's properly done, it will only take a few weeks for the initial epinephrine type response to be visibly reduced. And that's usually the first step. And then they go into a plateau. And then when you work on the other part, which is a norepinephrine, then the person will draw closer and closer towards early part of stage 3C when they come in at the end part of stage 3C, closer to 3D.